On this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, Presbyterian plays a pair of longtime foes in Charleston Southern and Gardner Webb. We'll talk about those games with Coach, break down the highlights, and preview two games at home sweet home for the Blue Hose this week. All that and more on this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. By Fats Cafe of Clinton, making your tailgate deliciously easy. And by Coca-Cola, the official soft drink of Presbyterian College.
Welcome to this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball with the coach, Gregg Nibert. I'm Ryan Rial. Coach, a couple games to talk about, Charleston Southern and Gardner Webb. We'll talk about Charleston Southern first, and we were talking before the show, and you know, starts really doing in lately here.
Well, it is, and we've really had to take a look at that as a staff and just evaluate everything on. One thing is our Achilles heel right now is just turning the ball over. I think everybody's trying really extremely hard and turning the basketball over and having some really bad turnovers that they're not just turnovers, they're steals and leading, having some backcourt turnovers against Charleston Southern when they're pressing us and that leads to easy baskets where we don't even get our defense set. And we really don't know how good our defense is because, we're turning the ball over so much and points off turnovers. And it's like interceptions or fumbles and they're being run back for touchdowns. Right. We've got to slow down. We got to really have slow down our offense a little bit. After the first 4 minute, break, we can't be down 13-2 or 11-2. So slowing the game down a little bit, really taking care of the basketball in both halves and really going to need to do that against, two good opponents this week.
We've talked about him a lot. Ed Drew again in that game, 13 points. And if you look at conference only numbers for you guys, he's less than a point behind JV in scoring and he leads the team in rebounds.
Well, I really am proud of Ed. And he really has been probably one of the most consistent players all season long, and that's really what you want a senior to do. We've moved him out there to the four position, which he's done a great job there, and going with a little size inside with Austin Venable and Armel TT, and hopefully that's going to move JV up to the three, so Reggie at the point, and Will Adams and Darius at the two, so we really think that's going to be a good move for us, but so proud of Ed and what he's done his senior year.
Absolutely. I think we're going to see him in just a second as we take a look at the highlights from the game against Charleston Southern.
Game highlights are brought to you by
and we're looking down there to get the ball inside, set a little back screen and trying to get the ball down inside. Good flash high there by Ed and tremendous job. They played off of him and he shot that 17 footer, which Ed's really good at that jump shot right there. Again, Will Adams hitting a wide open shot, which was great. And good little run there, on-ball screen. Beautiful job there, kind of run a little on-ball screen action here. We finish it up, driving it in there, going inside, and great pass there, and good job of getting the ball down inside. They pressed us a little bit, we hit in the middle there. Again, Will hitting the ball right there to Ruben, and Ruben getting an and-one. Great pass there by Will Adams. Great contest by Darius, great rebound. Good job here. We're pushing the ball, Reggie. Trying to take it right to the rub spot, pitching the ball ahead to Darius. And Darius is really shooting the ball really well. Great pass there in the post to Ed. And great post move down there with his left hand. We just need to get a lot more of that action right there. Again, we take the ball to the baseline. We're swinging it. They don't go out there and guard Ruben. And Ruben takes a little 5-7 pull-up jump shot. Really, Ruben's doing a great job coming off the bench. Good contest there by Ruben. Good hustle there by Darius. Again, pitch it out there. Don't have anything. Great skip pass there by Jaron. Again, can we get it inside? Trying to get it inside there. Going to run now a little set play action. Again, good screen there and great screen and pull up jump shot there by Reggie Dillard off that down screen. They go a little bit of zone. Again, Darius is shooting 40% plus from the three-point line. Again, we break the press. They're going back into a zone because we have stress getting the ball inside. And they're in foul trouble. We're in the 1-1. Again, good drive there. And great finish there again by Reggie. Good defense there. Great defense. Trying to push the basketball. Again, right. Another great skip pass there. Great pass inside. And great finish again, going up and under there with Ed Drew. Again, Ruben driving the ball to the basket up there to up that high post. Again, Armel Titi, we got him in and came in there late in the game. What a tremendous job he did down there on the block. Again, looking inside. Again, another great pass in there. Great offensive rebound by Armel, and great finish in there. And him and Austin are really going to do a great job there in that post position.
Well, Coach, you saw it there. You talked about it. One thing you were able to do in that game, Ruben Arroyo at that and one exemplified it. And you mentioned foul trouble. You guys got to the line 23 times in that game.
Well, we did. And that we got back to one really wanting to stress getting the ball down inside, which that was the most positive thing is we went to the free throw line. We did get the ball down inside. Again, you know, not to beat a dead horse, but we've got to take better care of the basketball. And that's what really is hurting us, points off turnovers. And we're going to, you know, kind of slow it down just a little bit more, but open up the game a little bit. We're kind of standing around, and hopefully our offense here can let guys have a little more, a little bit of freedom here, but spreading the floor out a little bit and making sure, like I said, we got to make sure of our passes. We got to make sure that we're going to throw it to the right colored jerseys here.
Right.
And that's going to be big for us, is not turning the basketball over.
It was neat last week. You guys got to be home for a little bit, play Charleston Southern home. You also got a visit from former PC football player and perennial NFL Pro Bowler Justin Bethel there.
Yeah, how cool was that?
Yeah,
he was at our practice and everything in there, and I told him I needed to borrow $5, but he said he didn't have it, so I don't know about that.
I don't know if he's got eligibility to make sure he could step in there as well. Well, Coach, you know, coming from that Charleston Southern game, it's going to be nice to, we'll talk about it later, but nice to finally get back home and get a game at Templeton.
Well, it sure was, and like I said, we had some nice games earlier in the year against Furman and VMI, and we're still searching for that 40-minute game of number one, we said before the season even started, is this basketball team has to have 9 turnovers or less. We've had 22 and 20, you know, turnovers.
Yeah,
and,
tough to win that way.
We've got to get down that to 9, which means we're getting 10 more shots, which means they're getting 10 less shots. Mm-hmm. So it's a double-edged sword when you turn that ball over.
Definitely something to work on going forward. All right, we're going to take our first break. When we come back, we're going to take a look at the highlights from Gardner-Webb, as well as our offensive, defensive, and hustle plays of the week. That's when we return to Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
Watching a cow.
Oh, what's it doing?
Impressions.
Power up your morning with a new 300-calorie egg white grill. Only at Chick-fil-A.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Bojangles. It's bow time. And by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Jeff Smith and Allstate.
Welcome back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. Coach, let's talk Gardner-Webb. You know, you guys have been really emphasizing defense. You got them to 40%, around 40% shooting. Yes. It's just the turnovers kind of did you in on that one.
And I had my assistant, you know, just do the stats off when we were able to get our defense set, what was our defense? Because I don't even think we know how good our defense is because we're having all these turnovers. Mm-hmm. And we were like a 0.74 OER, which was less than, 40% shooting. We're not getting they had 19 steals, Gardner-Webb. Steals, not turnovers, steals out of 21 turnovers. And those steals led to 24 points. And the two started both halves, Ryan, really, really hurt us. Mm-hmm. We started out down 13-2 in the first 4 minutes of the half. Mm-hmm. In the second half, we start down 14-2. Mm-hmm. So right now, that's 27-4 in your first 4 minutes of the game and game over. Right. Even though we really fought back, and I was so proud of the guys, but you can't, the start of your games and the start of each half are so critical in a game.
And you're able to put together a 14-1 run just, when you're, like you said, starting from behind like that, it's tough to cut into a deficit like that.
You're exactly right. Again, we got to slow the game down a little bit your first 4 minutes here. I told our guys if we, 30-second shot clock and handed the ball over, threw it out of bounds, you shouldn't be. The possessions you got. We got way too many possessions in that first 4 minutes.
Reggie Dillard was able to put the ball in the basket for the tune of 18 points. Let's see how the Blue Hose did with our highlights against Gardner-Webb.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
We really had some nice offensive plays, when we didn't turn it over. Great offensive rebound there by J.V. Milner. He really played one of his best games. I was so proud of him. Great baseline out of bounds play and great screening there by Ed and a great jumper by Darius. Great job out there, J.V., contesting that shot. Great offense right there, and Reggie Diller taking the ball to the basket here. We got some good offensive plays, like I said, when we didn't turn it over. A little on-ball screen there. And this is really exciting here for Austin Venable. He played his best game of the year. Going 4-for-6, we got him in the starting lineup here. Again, they're playing our on-ball screen now. Great pass there to Reggie to J.V., and what a great power move that was by J.V. Milner at 6-7. Getting run a little baseline out of bounds play to get it in, going into offense. Jaron's got the ball there. Again, good screen there by Austin. Good curl there by Reggie. And this is a great, really pretty nice one-on-one move, kind of a fadeaway, and Reggie has the shot clock's going down. He really believes in himself. Run a little home run right there. They were all out all over self and press offense. And good call there, and guys did it. Then another great pass there by Reggie. They were fronting the post, and good pass in there to Ed. Again, when we don't turn the ball over and give this team a chance to shoot, we can put the ball in the basket. Another little play right there. We get the ball inside to J.V. Milner. Great pass by Ed. Great hustle there by Ruben. Great rebound by J.V. Pushing the ball. Good job running the floor by Ed. Again, great pass there by J.V. over the top, and great left hand there by Ed. Again, second half action here. Run a little UCLA action, good on ball screen, looking for the layup. Really need to move the ball. We kind of got out of offense here, and this is a really good drive here by Reggie, and should have been an and one. Got hammered right there. Good job posting up there. Watch Austin post up right there. Quick move, and Austin making that left-hand hook.
Nice hook.
Again, really proud of Austin on his play. He's got a dunk. Great skip pass there by Jaron, and great three-point shot by J.V. Milner, freshman. Get another pass there inside to Ruben, and Ruben making a really nice bounce pass in there to Austin. We scored 37 points in the second half, all right, which that's what this team's capable of. And we've got to score, we can do that the whole entire game, but you can't do it though when you turn the ball. Great ball movement there, great passing the ball. Again, pass it back out. Great shot fake, and another great, beautiful shot by Darius, and that was a great assist. We had 16 assists. We only had 6 the other night against Charleston Southern. Another great pass there, but we had 22 turnovers. Again, great drive in there, good kick, good on-ball screen. Going over there, setting it up. Good job by Armel. Throw the ball right back. Good job there by Ed, making one more. Again, Darius really shooting the ball perfect. Again, we need to move the ball. Great pull back and step back there by Darius, creating space there. Darius is one of the best guys to do that. Run a little on-ball screen action here late in the game. Again, good drive there, a nice pass, and great finish. Beautiful job.
Coach, offense certainly looked clicking there, and I teased it before we went to highlights, and we've talked about it a lot, getting Reggie Dillard involved, driving the lane, 18 points for him, season high.
And that was, you know, we got to get guys in their best positions. We've been jumping around, you know, with Devon being out, and, you know, and then he is in, and then moving Darius at the point, and we really found, finally, you know, Reggie playing the point guard position. He really needs to drive that ball and get fouled. He got to the free throw line 9 times. He had 6 assists, and getting him comfortable with that position only is going to get better and better. And Darius over there at the 2, along with Will Adams and JV at the 3, finally gives us some continuity and consistency. And I think we'll do nothing but get better and better as the season goes on with those 3 positions.
We saw highlights from him as well. Austin Venable getting that hook shot. Played over 20 minutes on Saturday against Gardner-Webb.
Well, and that's what he showed too. Both him and Darius really started for us last year. They played a lot of basketball. Darius, I think, is giving him a shot there at the 2 position along with Will. And then, you know, going to give Austin a look starting back in here. He's really done a good job at practice, got over his sickness, so I think he can really help us as well.
Absolutely. Can't teach height. All right, well, we've been talking about offense. Let's just keep rolling with offense as we take a look at our offensive play of the week, brought to you by Steve Crow of Foothills Motorsports.
Well, again, they're playing a little zone against us because we got him in foul trouble, moving the ball against the zone, trying to get it inside there to Ruben. Good job there by Darius, trying to gap it a little bit. Again, great look there by Darius. And great move there by Armel TT to score that basket. Great job.
Armel TT inside after the great ball movement there. Excellent to see on the offensive side of the ball. All right, now for defense, let's take a look at the defensive play of the week, brought to you by Swain Brown Accounting Services and Upstate Insurance Consultants.
Well, we got down here, started picking up a little bit in our press. Good hustle there coming from behind. Really great hustle by Jared and Darius up there at the top of that zone. Again, little baseline screen. Good job stepping up there, Ed. Good job with his footwork there. Reggie, we need to pass that off. Good job there. Great defense there, and they have a turnover, keeping him in front of us.
Just beautiful switching there, keeping the ball in front, making sure Charleston Southern not able to convert on offense. All right, now for the hustle play of the week, brought to you by former PC coach and player Dan Nunnery.
Again, the hustle play here is again, Darius is over there on the ball. Will Adams now takes that pass. Good job moving in there by Ed. Good job coming around there by Reggie. All right, good pressure right there. Will Adams coming up with that great steal and good hustle there by Will Adams, a senior.
There's the senior leadership and experience of Will Adams. Great to see. Great young man. Happy for him on that play. All right, now we're going to take our final break. When we come back, we'll talk about the health of the Blue Hose with the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report, as well as our Baird Truck and Trailer Sales preview to next week's opponents. All that and more when we return to Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
If you're considering joint replacement surgery, ask yourself these questions. Is my orthopedic surgeon experienced in joint replacement? Does he listen to my concerns? Explain all my options? Will he manage my pain? Will he help me regain the active life I want? The orthopedic surgeons of Palmetto Bone and Joint are proud members of Newberry Hospital's award-winning joint replacement team. We're among the best in the state and nation for hip and knee replacement. You have a choice. Palmetto Bone and Joint.
Let's go! Oh yeah! Reach for the sky! We go! Yeah! Yeah!
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
There once was a family, a lot like this one, and they were traveling far away where there were no Bojangles. The family needed breakfast, but they got a late start. They pulled up to a drive-thru of a strange restaurant, and a loud voice boomed, "We stopped serving breakfast at 10 a.m.
Oh, honey.
At Bojangles, we've always served breakfast all day. Come in for a pork chop biscuit today. Bojangles, it's bow time.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Matt Davis State Farm Insurance of Clinton. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there. Cooper Motor Company, sales and service of Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram trucks since 1938. Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
Welcome back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. Coach, two games at home, but first let's talk about, you know, not the most fun segment of the week, but the palmetto bone and joint injury report.
Well, it's, you know, we've kept Dr. Milner and Nelson Jones really busy this season, and you don't really like to have any injuries. And, man, we've had our fair share of, obviously, Miles McGregor going down with a really bad ankle, and he's out for the year. We're redshirting him, and then Devon's knee injury, and unfortunately, we just found out that he's going to be out for the year, but, well, we might be able to get a hardship waiver that he will have, 2 years with it. So we're really excited about that. But, man, a guy that was really, driving, meaning breaking the defense down and really playing good defense, and really going to miss him, but excited about him hopefully getting two more years. Sure. And then, J.C. Younger, injured his elbow at Winthrop and being out for 4 weeks. So we really lost two starters that have really hurt us. But injuries are part of it. You got to step up, and we've got to, keep going here. But we really wish those guys the best, and so sorry, especially about Devon, because he was really having a tremendous year.
Absolutely. That one game he came back, it was great to see. So wishing them the best. All right. Now let's take a look at our Baird truck and trailer sales next week's preview.
Next week's preview is sponsored by Baird Transport for all your logistical and material transport needs.
Coach, you get to stay at home for two games. Mm-hmm. It's been a rare thing. You don't get to do that very often. Yeah. UNC Asheville and Longwood this week.
Well, I think going to UNC Asheville is saw them play the other night against Winthrop at Winthrop, and it was a Donnybrook. I think those right now, UNC Asheville, and I think Winthrop's in first place and Asheville's in second, but I think there's no doubt those two are the two best teams right now in the league. Asheville is unbelievable in terms of the way they steal the basketball, and right now we can't have any turnovers, so that's really going to be a challenge for us. Sure. They do a tremendous job on the ball, poking at it, and when you drive it, they don't come to help, they come to steal it. So taking care of the ball against Asheville is really going to be big, but we're excited to see where we are against the top team in the league, and they've got a really good team, and they play as a team, they really pass the ball, and it's going to be a really big test for us on Thursday against Asheville.
Absolutely, and then Longwood Saturday. It'll be nice because you'll be welcoming some alumni back and a key team that you remember and coach.
Well, we're excited. The 96-97 team that won the league and went to the NCAA Division II tournament, that team is back, so we're excited about that. And then it's also alumni weekend, so we're excited about all the alums that really come back. And two really alums that have been tremendous, and one is unfortunately Dave Thompson from Columbia passed away a couple weeks ago, and what an unbelievable player he was, along with Bruce Thompson, who everybody thought they were brothers, but they really weren't. But really, they were best friends. Mm-hmm. Bruce one game had 50, and they said, Dave said, I can beat that. And the next game, he had 51. But Bruce will be back with his lovely wife, Marjorie. Mm-hmm. And really want to thank that era. That was really kind of the most successful start to success of Dorm Sloan and that group right there, but welcome back all of our alums, and especially, Bruce Thompson.
Always great to see Bruce and Marjorie right behind press row there. There's customary seats. Always happy to see them. And then, Coach, you will be occupied Thursday night with UNC Asheville, but a great award for you and your lovely wife, Peggy, and your family with the South Carolina Great Friend of Kids Awards by Adventure.
Well, it is. And Adventure is a museum down there, which, loves kids, and it's all about kids. Aflac is sponsoring that, and Children's Trust, which nominated us for the award, and it's all about the children, and Peggy decided 10 years ago of wanting to do this foster care, and one of the greatest blessings that's been our family, and she's been the leader in all that, and we've been blessed to have over 40 children and in our home and abused and things like that, but trying to give these children a voice that to take care of them and DSS and law enforcement and judges and everything, to give these children a voice, especially when there's been neglect, the repeated neglect or or child abuse. That it is a great story when these kids can, you know, find two good loving parents and it working out. But it's really, we're really humbled and really thankful for that award as well.
Absolutely. Congratulations to you and your family on that and your continued work with that. It's great to see. If you haven't heard the story, check it out on the internet, gobluehost.com. You can search for that as well. A couple years ago, you know, WYFF and Turner Sports did a wonderful piece on you guys, and it's certainly great work to see. Okay, well, that'll leave it here for us. GoBlueHose.com has all your information for all PC athletics and men's basketball schedules. Two big games at home, don't miss them this week. And when they're on the road, you can check out BigSouthSports.com for live road games as well for free. And then check us right back here next week on Carolina CW and GoBlueHose.com. For the coach, Gregg Nibert, I'm Ryan Rial. We'll see you next week on Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
Inside Blue Hose Basketball was brought to you by
Smith Chevrolet of Lawrence, providing premier new car sales and service in Lawrence for over 60 years. By Palmetto Bone and Joint, the official orthopedic care provider for PC Athletics. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College.